NBA Draft Week is finally here, with the main event coming on Thursday night, so we are now at the point where every team is buckling down, honing in on the players they will be hoping to select when the time comes. Typically, the best players that will be selected early on get most of the attention by fans and the media, but as we see year in and year out, there is typically always tons of talent available later on at the end of the first round and even in the second round that can prove to provide plenty of value to teams, which brings us to the topic of today's video. Today, we'll be discussing 5 players that I believe are hidden gems in this year's draft class, meaning that they will more than likely hear their names called late at the end of the first round, during the second round, or could even go undrafted based on predictions, but I believe they will prove everyone wrong and outperform those expectations when they do get a chance at the next level. Before we start though, I wanted to thank Rhino Shield for sponsoring today's video. Rhino Shield is a phone case company with the highest quality cases on the market, and specifically for all of you watching right now, they just launched their new premium NBA phone case merchandise for the best way to represent your favorite teams. All NBA teams are available in both phone case and AirPod containers in tons of different designs, so make sure to go check them all out. On top of the NBA collection, they also have collaborations with different games, companies, and content creators for any of your other non-sports interests. You can even design your own case with your photos, names, and texts. Rhino Shield cases provide extreme impact protection, so you never have to worry about breaking your phone case ever again. These cases ship worldwide, and with free shipping on qualified orders, they have a lifetime replacement warranty that gives you free replacements if anything does happen to it, and they are available for all iPhone models and many Android flagship devices as well. The link is down in the description for you to go check out for yourself, and make sure to use code HOOPS for 20% off your order in the first week after this video launches. Now, with that being said, let's start the video. The first hidden gem we'll be discussing today is Nashawn Bones Highland from VCU. Highland took a big leap this season at VCU in his sophomore campaign, emerging as a 3-level scorer who averaged about 20 points per game with supreme confidence. When I say that there isn't a spot on the floor Highland isn't confident shooting from, I mean every word of it, because he easily has the deepest range in the draft shooting the basketball. He's crafty, he does well creating spaces to get his shot off, and through those moves, he'll pull up for a shot well beyond the 3-point line and make it at a reliable rate, and that kind of skill set is obviously more valuable than ever in today's NBA game. He's currently predicted by most mock drafts I've seen to be picked at the end of the first round as best case scenario, and he could slip into the second round worst case scenario, and then there are obviously a few reasons for that. He will need to work on his overall decision making and shot selection at times, and he'll need to add some strength to do a better job holding his own on defense, but I think his shot-making ability will shine through at the next level and make any team that takes him happy. The next hidden gem we'll be discussing is Dacian Nix, who played for G League Ignite this season. Nix was one of the players who chose to play in the G League instead of going to college this year, so he was playing against other grown professionals, getting invaluable experience along the way. However, he individually had a pretty up and down season there, so after starting the year viewed as a potential lottery pick, his draft stock has tanked to where he will almost assuredly be picked in the second round, with a chance at going even undrafted, which seems crazy to me. I may be one of the few still here, but I firmly believe in his talent, and I think many people have been way too harsh on him this season, again in a year playing against much tougher competition than the other prospects. Nix is a prototypical floor general point guard who has excellent court vision, works very well in half-court sets and pick and rolls, and plays very smart basketball. The reason why scouts have become so negative on him is because he didn't exactly shoot the ball very well in the G League, and I think that is a bit of an overreaction. Nix has a strong 6'5" frame, and his feel for the game is reminiscent to many of the best backup point guards in the game right now. His shooting will improve over time, and whoever takes that chance on him will end up with terrific value. The next hidden gem we'll be discussing is Quentin Grimes from Houston. Grimes has been a college player for 3 years playing at both Kansas and Houston, and he's coming off of a stellar season in which he shot the absolute lights out. The appeal with Grimes assuredly stems from his shooting ability, and this year he put it fully on display, attempting over 8 threes per game, making 40% of his shots from deep, being an obviously very impressive feat. At the NBA level, he'll ideally be someone used off-ball to space the floor and knock down shots when the ball gets swung to him, but if the defenses overplay his jumper, he can attack off the dribble and get to his spots inside as well in order to keep the defenses off balance. Plus, defensively, he has an incredibly high motor and was an integral part of Houston's dominating defensive attack that stemmed from a lot of their success for the season. He brings 3-and-D play at a very high level and should be a pretty safe pick, especially when you consider he will likely be taken at the end of the first round or possibly the second round. The next hidden gem we'll be discussing is Jason Preston from Ohio. Preston was one of the biggest feel-good stories from the season, emerging seemingly out of nowhere at Ohio after an improbable journey that I highly suggest you all go look into. But as a player now, he is built to be a combo guard who can find success at either guard position, and at 6'3", with a tantalizing 6'8" wingspan, he has the whole package to be a gem on both sides of the floor. Offensively, Preston's a hyper-efficient scorer, shooting over 50% from the field and about 40% from three over his last two seasons. But his best asset as a player is his playmaking and passing ability. He ranked 6th in Division 1 in assists per game last season, and he has tremendous feel for how to operate in the teeth of the defense to then locate the open man and deliver a perfect pass. The reason why he's seen by most as second-round talent is because he played at a mid-major, and he lacks the athleticism that NBA teams like, but I see past that and know he'll be able to succeed because he just has a great feel for the game. And finally, the last hidden gem we'll be discussing today is Josh Christopher from Arizona State. As has been a common theme in this video, Christopher is another player who absolutely has as much raw talent as any guard in this class, but his draft stock dipped a bit after his one season in college because his play was a bit inconsistent. Christopher has all of the physical tools you can want from a shooting guard at 6'4", with a 6'9" wingspan, and his game is so silky smooth when he has the ball in his hands. Christopher came into college as someone who was already a pretty well-known guy with tons of social media success, and he was a McDonald's All-American, and he definitely had a few outings this season where he looked like a terrific scoring threat against anyone, but his season was filled with inconsistency, which has reasonably sparked more concern by scouts. However, looking deeper, there's a lot to like about his game right now. Christopher ranked as one of the best players in all of college at scoring off the dribble around the basket in terms of efficiency, and his burst and athleticism really shine when he attacks. At the NBA Draft Combine, he also demonstrated that he could produce in other areas besides scoring, by grabbing tons of rebounds and dishing out some beautiful assists, so the idea that he's just a gunner is not true. Christopher is another player who likely won't hear his name called until late in round 1, or possibly round 2, but I think genuinely he has as much talent as some of the guys who will be picked in the lottery, and will easily outperform his draft stock. And with that being said, that's all I have for you today. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below who you think is a hidden gem in this year's draft. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.